So see the property that differentiate physical and chemical adsorptions. In that first one, intermolecular forces. Intermolecular forces that involved in this adsorption. So in physics option, what are the intermolecular forces between adsorbate and adsorbent? Yes, van der Waals forces. Here, van der Waals forces. But in chemis option, covalent bonds. Covalent bonds in chemis option. Second one, strength of bonding. Strength of bonding. You know, physics option is a very weaker. Why? Because in this van der Waals were very weaker forces, na? That's why weaker, it is stronger. Third one, reversibility. You know, physical adsorption is reversible, whereas chemical adsorption is irreversible. It is reversible because adsorption, desorption takes place simultaneously. But it is only adsorption. To cause a desorption, it is very difficult. So, irreversible. That means only one direction. In only one direction, it occurs. It occurs in two directions. That means adsorption and desorption, both will occur. Fourth one, enthalpy of adsorption. That means delta ADSH. This is called what? Enthalpy of adsorption in kilojoules per mole. Enthalpy of adsorption. You know, in physics option, it is enthalpy of adsorption is less, but here more. It is around 20 to 40. It is some 80 to 240 kilojoules per mole. Enthalpy of adsorption, I already explained that. Enthalpy of adsorption means it is the amount of heat released when one mole adsorbate is adsorbed. So that is, this is released energy. That means you should put negative sign. Negative sign, that means released energy 20 means delta H minus 20. Here released energy 80 means delta H minus 80. Released energy always expressed with negative sign. Okay, so here along with negative sign I am writing. So here released energy is 20 to 40. So here enthalpy of adsorption, here I am writing released only. Released energy, okay. So it is less, there more. Next, fifth one. What is the temperature where it occurs more efficiently? So, more temperature effect. Temperature. So, to occur this physical adsorption, low temperature is required, whereas chemical adsorption takes place at a high temperature. Temperature. Low temperature is required, high temperature is required. What is the effect of temperature? So with increasing temperature, with increasing temperature, with increasing temperature, this van der Waals adsorption or physical adsorption decreases. Physical adsorption decreases with increasing temperature, whereas chemical adsorption first increases and then decreases.
First increases,
reaches a maximum and then decreases.
Seventh one.
What is the effect of pressure?
Increasing pressure. Increasing pressure.
You know, increasing pressure increases physical adsorption. Increases when you increase the pressure of adsorbate gas, this physical adsorption increases faster and attains
constant value. Attains a constant value.
Increasing pressure increases the rate of physical adsorption, but after some time it attains a constant value. What about chemical adsorption? In chemical adsorption, pressure effect is negligible. Negligible effect. Pressure effect is negligible.
Eighth one.
Number of layers formed. Number of layers formed. Here in physical adsorption, multi-layers are formed. Multi-layers, that means more than one layer are formed in physical adsorption. Physical adsorption is not confined to a single layer. It involves multi-layers, whereas chemical adsorption, unilayer formation takes place. Unilayer, that means a single layer formation takes place. Next. Let's see the specificity. Specificity. You know, it is not specific. That means physical adsorption takes place on all surfaces. There is no specific surface. On all surfaces, physical adsorption takes place. But you know, chemical adsorption is highly specific. Highly specific. That means only particular substances are chemically adsorbed on particular adsorbates. Hydrogen gas is chemically adsorbed on nickel surface. Okay, so that is highly specific. Nature of adsorbate and adsorbent. Nature of adsorbate and adsorbate. Generally, physical adsorption depends on the nature of adsorbate gas, not on the adsorbate. Only on adsorbate. Physical adsorption depends only on adsorbate. How easily liquefiable gases are adsorbed more. Easily liquefiable gases means HCl, SO2, ammonia, these are easily liquefiable gases. Just by compression, they can be liquefied. But hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, they are not liquefied easily. So, such gases are non-easily liquefiable gases. They are adsorbed lesser. So, physical adsorption depends only on the nature of adsorbate. How easily liquefiable gases are adsorbed more. But this physical adsorption does not depend on the nature of adsorbate. Whatever be the adsorbate, physical adsorption takes place. But in chemical adsorption, on both, depends on both adsorbate and adsorbate. Chemical adsorption depends on both adsorbate and adsorbent. Here, there is no such correlation. Here we are saying more easily adsorbable gases are adsorb more easily liquefiable gases are adsorbed more. Such a correlation we can't give in the case of chemisorption. There are some other factors that decide the adsorption of substances chemically on adsorbents. So this is the 10th factor. Next, 11th one, ease of desorption. Ease of desorption. Desorption means, already I said, escaping of already adsorbed molecules from the surface of adsorbent. There is adsorption already, but those adsorbed molecules, if leave the surface, that is called desorption. Here, ease of desorption is easy, very easy, because the intermolecular forces are van der Waals forces, that's why. But very difficult in the case of chemical adsorption. Ease of desorption is very easy in physical adsorption, that is very difficult in chemical adsorption. 12th, energy of activation. Energy of activation. What is this? We compare the rate of a reaction by activational energy. A reactant to be converted into product, it has to gain certain energy. That energy is called activational energy. That activational energy in the case of physical adsorption, very less. But in the case of chemical adsorption, it is very high. If activational energy is more, the rate of that process is less, inversely proportional. Rate of reaction, activational energy, inversely proportional. So between these two, which occurs more fast? Yes, physical adsorption occurs more fast than chemical adsorption. Because of this high activational energy for chemical adsorption, because of high activational energy, it is called activational adsorption also. So there is another word for chemical adsorption, activated adsorption. Why it is called so? Because of this high activational energy. Okay, so these are all differences between physical and chemical adsorption.